In this video, I'm going to show you how you can control your computer with a video game controller. Like this. As a bonus, I'm going to show you how you can start and stop controlling it with just the press of a button on the controller. I'm going to assume that you have Python installed already. If not, please just check out the video right up here and go ahead and get that installed if you want to follow along. All right, to control your computer with a video game controller, you're going to need two Python packages, PyGame and PyAutoGUI. So let's go ahead and install those right now. All right, so we have PyGame. We'll go ahead and install that. And I already have it. And PyAutoGUI. I already have that as well. PyGame allows you to take inputs from anything that's connected to your computer, including this guy, even if it was connected through Bluetooth. If you've ever watched this video here, then you probably already know that you can move your mouse and click things with PyAutoGUI. So the real magic happens when you put the two packages together. All right, so for this project, we want to basically do these four things. We want to get button presses from the controller. We want to make the button presses click things. Then we want to be able to get joystick movements from the controller. And finally, make the joystick move the mouse. Pretty simple. So those are the four steps. To start out, we're going to import PyGame and PyAutoGUI, and then initialize PyGame, initialize the joystick part of PyGame, and then create an empty list of joysticks. This part will make sense in just a second. Then we're going to create a while loop that will run forever because it's while true. And we're going to then start to get events from PyGame. The one event that we really care about is PyGame.joyDeviceAdded. Is kind of joyful, I guess, actually. When we get this event, we're going to create a joystick object by getting PyGame joystick and creating a joystick object with the event.deviceIndex. So that will be passed within this event. And then we're going to add it to our list of joysticks. So we'll have one. Great, so now we have a controller connected. Now outside of this loop, we're going to loop over our joysticks. So if no joystick was ever added, then this is an empty list, so nothing's going to happen here. But if a joystick was added because we've seen adding device, then we can see if joystick.getButton0 is true. And if it is, we're going to print subscribe. So let's go ahead and run this here. All right, so we are running. We see we got adding device, and you can see if I press X, we get a lot of subscribe being printed. If you want to go ahead and do that, feel free. Amazing. So now we know if X is being pressed. But what about the rest of the buttons? There's a lot more than just X on a PlayStation controller. So let's get those two. All right, I'm going to go ahead and just delete this here and get rid of some of this and uncomment all these. All right, so basically all we have here is exactly what we had before. And instead of just this, we have all of these other joystick things that we're listening to. I understand that's a little confusing that it says joystick. This is kind of maybe should be called controllers, but we're going to leave it as joystick. All right, if we go ahead and run this, we can see we get adding device. If I press X, I get zero. I don't know why I guess I can't draw things. If I press circle, I get one. If I press square, I get two. Triangle, I get three. And then for the D-pad over here, if I press right, I get right. Left, I get left. Up, I get up. And down, I get down. Great. So now we know when basically anything is being pressed on the controller. But we're not clicking anything yet. So let's hook it up to PyAutoGUI. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and delete this and get the next chunk of code down here. I'm not actually going to keep all of the buttons because we don't really need them in this case, but we're just going to change this here. And the only thing we're changing is just instead of printing something, we're just doing PyAutoGUI.click. Pretty simple. So let's go ahead and run that. So if we run that, we can then, if I press X, we can see that it's selected here. If I press X again, we can see it's selected there. But there's one issue, which is if I press and hold X, it clicks a lot, like really fast. This is great, but it's clicking a little bit fast. If it's going 60 times a second, then it's going to be really hard to double click something or click something just once accurately. So let's fix that. All right, we're going to go ahead and delete this and copy the next part. So all we have to do in order to fix this is we need to make sure that it doesn't allow us to fire this click function that often. Pygame actually tracks how many frames are running within our little script here. So in this case, we basically have a timer. So we can use this timer and basically track when the last time we pressed X was. And then we can allow X to only be pressed at most every 300 frames. So all we're doing here is initially we're getting the time from pygame.time get ticks. Then within our get button function, we see if time minus the pressed length, so 300, is greater than or equal to whatever the pressed last pressed X is. And if it is, we set last pressed X to time. So that way now we're moving up whatever the last pressed X is, and then we'll allow it to click. So if I run this, we can now see that it is way easier and way slower, I guess. So if I hold this, it opens and closes at most every 300 frames. Amazing. So now we can click stuff with our controller, but I still have to use my mouse in order to actually move my mouse. So in order to fix that, we need to get the joystick inputs. So let's do that next. All right, just as before, we're going to go ahead and delete this down to here. All of this code will be in the description down below. If you just see a link to my GitHub, feel free to go ahead and download it and play with it yourself. All right, so here we can see that we're basically doing everything we did before, but now we're going to get the axis of the joystick. So if we want the left stick axis, we're going to get axis 0. And this is for the left and the right. It's going to go between minus 1 and 1. If we want the left stick up and down, it's get axis 1. And if we want the right stick, it's just 2 and 3, same left and up and down. All right, we still have our get button, but we're not going to really test that. So let's go ahead and run this and see what happens. So you see, we're getting a bunch of things that are not quite zero because controllers, at least ones that you've used a fair bit, are usually never perfect. But if I move my left controller all the way to the right, we can see that we get almost a full one there. We get 0.9999. If I move it to the left, you can see we actually do get minus one. If I move it up, we can see the up is actually up down is getting minus one. And if I move it down, we can see that we're getting, again, almost one exactly. Great. So now all we have to really do is just hook it up to PyAuto GUI. So let's go ahead and again, delete this stuff and go ahead and get this code here and uncomment all this. Now, there's a lot that you might see going on here, and I'm actually going to comment out this because you'll see why we need this. So I've actually added in the X, circle, and triangle so we can actually use these if we want to. If you notice here, I've actually allowed us to right click using circle, which can be pretty cool. So for joystick movement, we can see that we have joystick.getAxis1. So this is the up and down, and getAxis0 is the left and right. So we have change Y and change X. So the way PyAuto GUI works for moving a mouse is you have to give it an X coordinate and a Y coordinate. So in order to know where the mouse is currently, because we need to either add some values to it or subtract some values or both, we need to get that position. So pyautogui.position will return the X and the Y for the mouse. Then we can also get the screen size with pyautogui.size. So we're gonna get the width and the height of the screen. That way we can make sure that we're not trying to just bash our mouse against the right side of the screen and try and make it go off the screen. Then all we have to do here is calculate our new X and Y, because we have our changed value. This can either be minus 1 to 1 or minus 1 to 1. So all we have to do now is just say we want the max value of either 0. So this is the case for if it becomes negative, we want it to be a 0. And we want the min value of basically the width of the screen. So that means if it's larger than the width of the screen, we want it to be less than that. And then we're just going to get the current X value and we're going to add our X value. Now, you'll see why we need these times 50s here and also why it's pretty cool. So if we go ahead and run this and I move my mouse right here, and I start scrolling this, you can see how incredibly fast that's moving. Look at it. It's like the sloth in Zootopia. That would be pretty lame if that's where we left it. So instead, let's multiply that result by 50. And let's go ahead and see how this works. So if we now go up, it moves up, down, left, right. And the best thing about this is because it's from negative 1 to 1, including it's basically, it can be a fraction, right? If it's 0.5, that means that if we move the controller a little bit, it also moves the mouse slowly. Whereas if we move it all the way, it moves it faster because it's basically moving it at 50 pixels per frame or whatever it is. Whereas if we move it just a little bit, it's just a little bit. As promised, let's now make it so that if you press the triangle button on your controller or whatever controller you have, that it disables the controller. Because maybe you're playing around with this and you want to be able to turn it off really quickly without stopping the program. So let's do that. So we're going to go ahead and again, just delete this stuff here and grab this next set, which again is basically the exact same thing. The only difference here is we've just added a Boolean. So all we have is this take inputs Boolean, and we're going to say that we want to take the inputs. And if triangle is pressed, then we're going to just set it to not take inputs. So if it was true and not take inputs, then makes it false. And not take inputs, if this is false, then makes it true. So in this case, if take inputs is true, then we're going to allow you to click and right click. And if take inputs is true, we're going to allow you to move the mouse with the joystick. All right, so let's go ahead and run this and take a look. So if I can move stuff still, I can press X to move the mouse. I can right click with circle. And if I want it to not really do anything anymore, I can just press triangle. And there we go. It stops. Now I can move it and nothing happens. Nothing's happening. But if I want to take control again, I can press triangle again. And now I can move it again. Pretty sweet. That's it. Now you can control your computer with a video game controller. You could even play a video game with the controller now on your computer. I guess you can probably do that already though. Or you could watch your favorite YouTuber. If you like this video, please go and click that like button down below. It really helps out the channel a whole ton. And while you're down there, consider subscribing. We actually have a lot more viewers than we have subscribers, so consider subscribing if you want to stick around. And also join our Discord community in the description down below. Remember, I'm Jake, you're awesome. And this has been Controlling Your Computer with the Video Game Controller. Cheers.